Pittsburgh and Baltimore, two cities separated by about a five-hour drive. Two great defenses since 2001 and two and fewest points allowed. 22 Pro Bowlers will be on the field in tonight's game, including three defensive players of the year, Reed and Lewis and Harrison on the Pittsburgh side. And Ben Roethlisberger 6-2 when he starts against Baltimore. The Ravens are 5-0 in games that Ben has not started in his seven-year career. So there is Roethlisberger. All eyes will be on him. But Pittsburgh won the toss and elected to defer. And with Ben, he'll await his turn because the Baltimore offense is going to get the ball. And there is Roethlisberger with a specially fitted shoe. And kicking off will be Sean Sweezum, who took over 3 weeks ago when they let Jeff Reed go. Reed had been there for a long time. And Sweezum was one of the big heroes last week with four field goals of 40 or more yards. David Reed, a rookie, is going to run back the opening kickoff. And John Harbaugh thinks that Reed can be the answer all the way down the stretch here. Drafted in the fifth round out of Utah. He will get the ball first tonight as he runs up and collects it at the 15-yard line and cuts across the field and gets around the corner, but a flag is thrown and another flag comes in at the end. So he brings it back out for the moment to the 36-yard line.
Return, holding, receiving team number 11. 10-yard penalty, first down.
So Terry McCauley with the initial call, and let's take a look at the Baltimore starters tonight.
Joe Flacco, University of Delaware.
Ray Rice, Rutgers University.
Anquan Boldin, Florida State University.
Derek Mason, Mumford High.
TJ Houshmandzadeh, Oregon State.
Todd Heap, Arizona State.
Michael Orr, North Memphis, Tennessee.
Ben Grubbs, Auburn University.
Matt Burke, Harvard.
Chris Chester, University of Oklahoma.
Marshall Yonda, Iowa.
Missing tonight is LaRon McClain, their fullback, such an integral part of the offense. They go three wide on first down. Flacco goes right to the air, and the pass is incomplete, and you can see Heat pulling up, reaching for his hamstring as he went down the field over the middle, and he's going to come out after the first play.
Well, as we well know, it is cold down there, and this is not good news whatsoever. At Houshmandzadeh on the outside, but here's Todd Heap, and watch him. This guy has been playing some of his best football of his career, such a big part of this offense, and he went immediately to the sideline.
So he goes to the bench. He had a 65-yard reception for a touchdown last week against Tampa Bay here on second and 10. Flacco checking off and rolling and then throwing, and that's incomplete, intended for Rice. Joe Flacco started his college career at Pittsburgh and then left there and went to Delaware. Last eight games at home, just one interception, and that came last week when Aqib Talib of Tampa Bay wound up with an interception that he collected between his ankles. He has been phenomenal since the second week of the season. Eight interceptions this season for Flacco, one of them on opening day, and then four more in the second game of the year, so only three over the past nine games. Third down and 10 out of the shotgun. And finally the pocket breaks down and down he goes. Ziggy Hood taking the spot normally occupied by Aaron Smith, who's been hurt for a good part of the season. Ziggy Hood gets the sack and it's a quick three and out.
Well, we call this the amoeba defense. Everybody's sort of up and walking around, but watch the protection. It's good. They brought two guys out of the secondary. Had plenty of time and just a late sack, a coverage sack by Ziggy Hood.
Sam Cook, who's having a very good season, will punt out of his own end zone. And Antonio Brown, a rookie from Central Michigan, will run it back. Brown is standing right now at the 50-yard line. And he collects it in his own 49. And a flag is thrown immediately as Brown gets back to the Baltimore 43. Terry McCauley, who has refereed two Super Bowls, will give us the call.
During the kick, holding, receiving team number 26. 10-yard penalty, first down.
That's on Will Allen. So all eyes right now on Roethlisberger and his mobility, and also will he take a lot more snaps out of the shotgun tonight? And how effective can he be? And how mobile can he be? And how durable can he be? Starting from his own 38-yard line. Running back is Rashard Mendenhall. And there's a short shotgun formation for Roethlisberger, who's 4 yards back, and then he hands the ball off to Mendenhall up to the 40-yard line. And Ben was telling us last night, we're going to do something that's a little surprising at the beginning of the game, and there it was. It's like a mini shotgun formation.
Yeah, it's what the colleges call the pistol formation, where they have the quarterback about 3 yards off the line of scrimmage and the tailback in behind. They just ran their power O play that they run a million times over, so the offense didn't change, just the formation.
Now you have five receivers and a more conventional shotgun set up, second down and 8. Four-man rush, and the pass is behind the intended target, Heath Miller. Let's take a look at the Pittsburgh offense.
Ben Roethlisberger, Miami University.
Rashard Mendenhall, Illinois.
David Johnson, Arkansas State.
Hines Ward, Georgia.
Mike Wiley, O'Perry Walter High School.
Heath Miller, Virginia.
Jonathan Scott, Texas.
Chris Kimoyatu, Utah.
Marquise County, Florida.
Ramon Foster, Tennessee.
Lozo Adams, Michigan State.
A lot of mixing and matching through the season along that offensive front. Isaac Redman is the third down back. He flanks Roethlisberger here on third down and 8. Only a three-man rush. Ben with that pump fake, and then he dumps it off to Redman, and Redman's going to run for a first down before he gets taken down. Out of bounds by Nakamura and Tavares Gooden. And now Redman comes up gimpy.
Ben Roethlisberger must have the biggest hand in captivity. I cannot believe he held on to this ball after this pump fake. Look at, I mean, it is cold down there, and it completely shifted the defense from one side of the field to the other. Comes back to Redman for a big first down. You don't need a good ankle if you can pump fake like this.
So far, so good. And again, the short shotgun or pistol here. First down at the 46-yard line. Behind him is Mendenhall. Ben protected well, and that pass is incomplete, intended for Miller. Second down, and let's take a look at the Baltimore defense.
Kalatingata, Oregon.
Kelly Gregg, Oklahoma.
Corey Redding, University of Texas.
Jarrett Johnson, Alabama.
Ray Lewis, University of Miami.
Jamel McClain, Syracuse University.
Terrell Suggs, Duke and Downey University.
Chris Carr, Boise State.
DeJuan Landry, Georgia Tech.
Ed Reed, the U.
Josh Russell, University of the Dirty Turf.
Suggs saluting his parents, Duke and Donald. Terrell went to Arizona State. Second down and 10. And that's a 2 or 3 yard pickup from Mendenhall, who then gets shoved back. One thing about these two teams, Chris, obviously through the years, and especially that 2008 AFC Championship game, it's as physical as it gets.
Yeah, and really, they're going to attack tonight. I mean, we've already seen Ben Roethlisberger. He doesn't miss as badly as we've seen him miss on two throws already tonight. I'm sure he's trying to get it figured out, just how to push off of that foot, but very uncharacteristic throws on a couple of the first runs that he's had.
Now you have Miller lined up in the backfield on third down and 8 because Redman went off, so they had to move the tight end into the backfield to stay in to block. And Roethlisberger will go down at his own 46-yard line. Halote Nata. Nata gets the sack, and there is Ben hunched over.
Halote Nata, if there's a better defensive lineman in the game, I don't know who he is. Sack number 6 on the season, a career high for him, and he is established early on. Oh, look at the bloody nose,
man.
For Ben.
So at first you think it's the foot, then you realize it's the bloody nose that he suffered.
And that nose is crooked.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh. Look at his nose. Mm.
So Roethlisberger goes to the sideline. The backup quarterback is Byron Leftwich. Daniel Sepulveda comes in to punt. Lardarius Webb is back at his own 5-yard line and is going to let it bounce at the one and bound through the end zone. And Baltimore will have it for the second time tonight at the 20 as they work on Ben. Sunday Night Football brought to you by Southwest Airlines. Find our fares online only at southwest.com. By BMW, the ultimate driving machine. By Bank of America and by Wendy's, you know when it's real. Baltimore Inner Harbor on this very cold night. Meanwhile, they're working on Roethlisberger, his uniform bloodied, the bloodied nose and maybe a broken nose, and they work on him as Baltimore has it at the 20. Willis McGahee is the running back. Here, McGahee gets stuffed in the backfield by Troy Polamalu, the safety who comes in on the run blitz and knocks him down for a 4-yard loss. And let's go back to the Roethlisberger hit.
Well, I can hear him screaming all the way from Pittsburgh here. All the fines, all the penalties on Steelers players. Here's a direct blow to the helmet of Ben Roethlisberger. Looks like it may have, at the very least, changed the shape of his nose. No penalty, no foul.
Hit him with the right hand first and then the left hand. Second and 14, and there's a draw to the 22 as Ray Rice comes in and a penalty. And that's going to go against Baltimore.
Well, from somebody who's had a few broken noses.
Offense number 74, penalties declined, third down.
That's the left tackle, Michael Orr.
I can tell you, it's no fun, but obviously you can play with it. But I never had, I probably broke my nose two or three times at least. I never had it go sideways like that. That's pretty nasty.
So between the nose and the foot, and we'll have to see about Ben and whether he comes back into the game again. Byron Leftwich is the number two quarterback. It's third down and 9 now from the 21-yard line. And it's floated and then juggled about 5 times and dropped by Ed Dixon, a rookie tight end out of Oregon. So Dixon, who might see more action tonight, especially since he had to come out after that first game, should have had it, juggled it, and then it fell to the turf.
What a great call, though. They ended up with Brett Kiesel, the injured defensive end, who's just returning from a hamstring, on a tight end down the field. And the young tight end just blew a huge opportunity.
Sam Cook to punt. Antonio Brown back at his own 35-yard line. And it's a short snap, but a whistle before the snap.
False start. Offense number 51. 5-yard penalty. Fourth down.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, wow.
I think that guy knows a little bit about special teams right there, John Harbaugh.
But it was fourth. It was fourth and 14 here.
Right there. Just a little movement before the snap from Brendan Iambadejo, one of their special team stars, who just blew a huge opportunity.
Oh, wow. On fourth and it's fourth and 14 now. It was fourth down and 9. And Cook's kick is a low line drive. It bounces at the 45, picked up at the 43 by Brown. And Brown will set Pittsburgh up with good field position. But the question is, who's going to come in? And for the moment, Ben puts the helmet on. He's ready to go again when we come back. So Roethlisberger comes back. It was Nada who came in and hit him and created what the Steelers are saying is not a broken nose, simply a bloodied nose. Semantics. The ball is at the 45-yard line. And Mendenhall to the 41-yard line. Richard Mendenhall, third year, number one pick out of Illinois in 08. And as a rookie in a Pittsburgh-Baltimore game in Pittsburgh early in the season, he was tackled by Ray Lewis and sustained a fractured shoulder and missed the rest of his rookie season, then took over as the starter the following year for Willie Parker. Second down and six. Now the pistol again for Roethlisberger, standing 4 yards back of center with Mendenhall behind him, and Ben's going to launch one for the end zone, and too far for Mike Wallace. Tough to overthrow Mike, but of course Mike was running out of room. He'd beaten Ladarius Webb in the end zone, third down and six.
Well, of course, Roethlisberger did not play in the first matchup, and Mike Wallace had several opportunities for big plays, but Charlie Batch couldn't get him the ball. That time Roethlisberger overthrew him, which is a very rare occurrence for one of the fastest players in all the NFL.
Third and six. Steelers send five receivers out, and the pass is caught, snatched out of the air by Antonio Brown, a yard short of the first down at the 36-yard line.
Well, Ben had no chance whatsoever. They've got the hot read coming off of the fact that Ray Lewis and one of the safeties was coming after him. Had to throw it quickly, got it out there, and Ladarius Webb did his job making the tackle before the first down. And in a game like this, you punt in this situation.
Or at least you line up the punt.
Yeah.
As did Baltimore. And Sepulveda with a kick that will be fair caught at the 8-yard line by Ed Reed. Ravens take over at that spot in a scoreless first quarter. That's a look at Pittsburgh, and on New Year's Day, hockey at Heinz Field. It's the Capitals and the Penguins. That means Alex Ovechkin and Sidney Crosby. The Winter Classic New Year's Day, Pittsburgh and Washington from Heinz Field right here on NBC. It's been a great series. Wrigley Field and Fenway Park. And out of Pittsburgh they go on New Year's Day on NBC. From the 8-yard line on first down, Willis McGahee picks up two. Let's take a look at the Pittsburgh defense.
Ziggy Hood, Missouri.
Casey Hampton, Texas.
Brett Kieslam, Grable High School. Go Buffs.
Lamar Woodley, University of Michigan.
James Ferrier, Virginia.
Lawrence Timmons, Florida State.
James Harrison, Kent State.
Brian McFadden, Florida State.
Troy Polamalu, University of Southern California.
Ryan Clark, LSU.
Ike T. Swagger University.
That Pittsburgh D, so good for so long. That run defense, averaging 3 yards per carry against the season, and that's tremendous. Rice is the back on second down, and Aiden Flacco is going to take a timeout.
Not in time, though.
You got a timeout. Prior to calling a timeout, delay of game, offense, 5-yard penalty, second down.
John Harbaugh came here in 08. A surprising choice, even the special teams coach, for the most part under Andy Reid at Philadelphia for a lot of years. And what a job he has done. And of course, his brother Jim is the head coach at Stanford. And he'll be a guy whose name will be tossed about at the end of the season
as a prospective
NFL head coaching candidate next year.
I think ranked number 4 in the country right now at Stanford. That's pretty impressive.
Second and 13 on the 5-yard line. Trying to give him a little bit more breathing room is Rice. Third down. What's the story with Todd Heat, hurt on the first play of the game? Andrea, what do you know?
Well, Al, he hurt his right hamstring. He went to the locker room. They tried to tape it up, but he is ruled out. And it's unfortunate because he's having one of his best seasons because he had remained healthy.
All right, Andrea, that means with Heat out, the other two tight ends are both rookies. Ed Dixon out of Oregon, third-round pick. Dennis Pitta out of BYU, a fourth-round pick.
And you also mentioned that fullback LaRon McClain out, so a lot of the power of this football team no longer there. You wonder if they might flirt a little bit with the spread offense now.
Third down and 12. And again, you've got a whistle before the snap here, and a false start.
False start, offense number 74. Half the distance to the goal. Third down.
That's Michael Orr, who was limited in practice this week, sprained his knee in the Tampa Bay game last week and had to come out in the second half.
And when you watch Michael Orr on tape, he has one of the fastest get-offs of the ball. And apparently the officials here thought it was a little too quick, and James Harrison did as well, as he gives the officials probably his only applause for the officials this entire year.
Third down and 15. This game to this point played in the Baltimore end. There goes Polamalu, who tries to get through and couldn't, and the pass is lofted to Anquan Boldin. And the former Arizona Cardinal takes it all the way to the 35-yard line. Live by the sword, die by the sword. Send your safety in. He can't get there, and that opens up the middle.
Well, Anquan Boldin coming across in motion. And the Steelers tried to bring a little pressure, which meant that Ryan Clark, who is not very fast, ends up with the newest acquisition, Anquan Boldin. And those are the big plays that decide these kinds of games.
61 yards from the shadow of their own end zone. And now Willis McGahee. It was 61 on a third down and 15 from the three.
Now watch Ray Rice right there in the middle of your screen pick up Troy Polamalu, which gave Joe Flacco just enough time to get that one off. Not many people, not many backs can make that block as well as Ray Rice can. He has been huge. He has been a Steeler beater over the years.
Second down and six. Roethlisberger with the bloody nose and the bloody uniform. Play fake. Flacco excels at that. Throws, screen set up, caught. And this is the tight end, Dixon, who takes the ball close to the 25-yard line. And that will move the chains.
Well, one of the things that Pittsburgh knows is that these backs are going to have to chip along with the tight end. So Baltimore's answer to that is we'll just run some screens off of it. That time it was Dixon just in there blocking, 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 and all of a sudden Flacco with three blockers in front flips it out there. But those are the, you go big shot down the field, you go screen, but you have to keep the protection going against the Steelers.
Under 5 minutes to play. No score. Opening quarter. Quick toss to TJ Houshmandzadeh, former Bengal and Seahawk, for a gain of a couple. It was Houshmandzadeh who caught the pass from Flacco at the end of the game with 32 seconds left in Pittsburgh on October 3rd that gave Baltimore the win.
And it was Brian McFadden who was covering him who gave it up. You're going to see the old Pittsburgh cross blitz. Sometimes when you're watching these two teams play, I know it's easy to follow the football, but if you can watch what they're doing on the defensive side a little bit as well, it is about as interesting as the NFL gets watching the Steelers and Ravens on the defensive side.
Pittsburgh's defensive coordinator, the Hall of Famer, Dick LeBeau. Pressure on Flacco, but he gets it away, and then it's tipped and it's incomplete. Off the hand of Rice and another penalty, and this one will go against Baltimore for a hold. Dixon may have gotten Woodley.
Yeah.
Holding. Offense number 83, 10-yard penalty, second down.
Indeed.
Well, they asked Ed Dixon to come in motion and block Lamar Woodley coming off the outside. You're a rookie. This is not a great assignment, but you've got a screen pass. You can't hold on a screen pass. You know, I mean, the whole point is let the rush come in there a little bit, and now you're backed up. And remember, this is a tough, windy night. Don't think you're going to see a bunch of 50-yard field goals in this one.
Temperature near the freezing mark. Ball to the 33-yard line. It'll be second down and 18. Flacco out of the shotgun. Three-man rush. Joe buys time. Looking and then throws, and the pass is caught, hauled in at the 26-yard line by Houshmandzadeh. Gain of 7, it'll be 3rd and 11.
Watch Lamar Woodley right here. This is what you're dealing with. And you've got Chris Chester, just a big professional guard, and he just gets mauled. Joe Flacco just stayed with this as long as he could. And that is some catch on the tail end. That's a veteran pro receiver, and they certainly have guys now that know how to make tough catches in tough situations. That's why they got Anquan Boldin, and why they feel like they were lucky to get T.J. Houshmandzadeh.
Did he get both down with possession? No challenge from Tomlin. Third and 10 from the 25. Flacco slings it to the outside, and it is caught there by Ed Dixon, close to the first down marker. Dixon working against Timmons that time.
Well, here's the rookie coming back and really doing what he does better. Ed Dixon is a much better receiver than he is blocker. That's a big play there. And then Michael Orr on the outside doing the best job that he has and trying to stay with Brett Kiesel, trying to stay with James Harrison with that banged up knee.
Picked up enough for a first down, so they've converted two third and longs. The ball is at the 14-yard line. And this is McGahee to the 15-yard line. This drive started back at the 8-yard line, and then they, because of a penalty, were pushed back to the 3, and there was that big pass to Bolden to set him up, and now they're trying to drive it in.
Well, I tell you, Casey Hampton right here, poor Chris Chester's having his hands full tonight. Casey Hampton just walking him backwards as well. That was about as good a half-yard run as I've seen in a while. Willis McGahee had to dodge three guys to get a half yard.
10th play of the drive. It is second down and 10. And that hard play fake that Flacco excels at a lot of time. And then Flacco throws him wide open for the touchdown is Anquan Bolden. Touchdown Baltimore.
So many times if a receiver can get to the back of the end zone behind the defenders, go one way and then come back the other way, the defenders lose them. They watch the quarterback. That time they're watching Joe Flacco. And Anquan Bolden made this look easy. Watch him. There we go. As they turn around and watch the quarterback, I'm going the other way. Thank you very much. Easy touchdown for a veteran player.
Seventh touchdown reception this season for Bolden, who came over from the Cardinals. And now you have a fight breaking out before the snap. It's the Ravens and the Steelers sooner or later. So it starts on an extra point. McCauley Screw has been very busy in this first quarter tonight.
Ball start. Offense number 65. 5-yard penalty. Try from the 7-yard line.
Chris Chester, that's more action than I've ever seen on a false start.
And an extra point.
Right.
There we go, right. Uh-oh. We're going to take James Harrison. James Harrison's had just about enough of everything here lately. But look what he did. He backed right out of it. He's seen enough of those envelopes from the league.
$125,000 worth. Now the extra point from 5 yards back by Cundiff is good. Billy Cundiff tacks on point number 7. It's Baltimore 7 and Pittsburgh nothing, with a little less than 2 minutes remaining in the opening quarter. Log on, if you will, to NBCSports.com/SNF Extra. That's what it will look like. A lot of good stuff here. Look at the left-hand column. There are the stats, and those are the real stats. As of the moment, 106 yards for Baltimore to 19 for Pittsburgh. That 92-yard drive with the two key plays, the third down conversions, one to Bolden, and then Bolden winds up with the ensuing touchdown. Cundiff, with a lot of touchbacks this season, has another one. More than half his kickoffs have resulted in touchbacks. Roethlisberger takes over at his own 20. 7-0 Ravens. These defenses since 2000. Points per game ranked 1 and 2 allowed. Yards per game allowed 1 and 2. Takeaways, the Ravens are number 1. Sacks, Pittsburgh number 1. So through the decade, these two teams excelling on that side of the ball. And you just watched Baltimore go 92 yards against that Pittsburgh defense. And that's the longest drive given up by the Steelers this season.
Yeah, and Dick LeBeau over talking to Bryant McFadden. It was McFadden who dropped the coverage that cost the Steelers the touchdown.
First down and 10. Roethlisberger taking the conventional snap here. He's lined up in regular shotgun and in the half shotgun or pistol tonight. And he hands the ball off to Mendenhall. And Mendenhall will pick up 7 yards out to the 27-yard line.
A Well, Ben Roethlisberger under center obviously has to put a lot more pressure on that foot, but he really is starting to move around a little bit better than what he did early on. You can only imagine what it's like to go out there with a bad foot, but the best thing that could happen to Ben Roethlisberger, a couple more seven-yard runs out of Rashard Mendenhall.
Bad foot, bloodied nose, second and a deuce, Mendenhall. Tackle to the line of scrimmage. You know, Chris, with Ben, a lot of people say, oh, he's a drama queen and all of the rest. But you know what? He is one tough dude.
Well, he doesn't look like a homecoming queen tonight. He's got blood everywhere. And I tell you, this Haloti Ngata is the guy that is probably their biggest nightmare on the, here we go, right outside here. And the Baltimore Ravens are putting him over on the Steelers' offensive right-hand side because they know that's the way they like to run.
Now Maloney Moore, the third down back, is in. Third down and two. But Sanders coming in motion. You've got three receivers on the left side. Roethlisberger looking that way and dumps it off for Moore as Ben hits the ground. And Moore tries to fight his way to the first down line and is either right on it or just short of it. The line judge coming in to mark it. If the nose of the ball is on the 30-yard line, it is a first down. Terrell Suggs, meanwhile, planted Roethlisberger. Wama signals to the bench, it'll be a first down. Nose of the ball touches the stripe, it is a first down, and it is.
Terrell Suggs is overwhelming Jonathan Scott at the left tackle position.
End of the first quarter, Baltimore 7, Pittsburgh nothing, and Sunday Night Football continues after these messages. Tonight's aerial coverage being brought to you by the film The Fighter.
That's appropriate.
Yes, for this game. Looking at Baltimore. Al Michaels, Chris Collinsworth, Andrea Kramer on this 34-degree Sunday night at M&T Bank Stadium. And as we start the second quarter, you've got Terry McCauley.
Baltimore has challenged the spot on the last play.
Well, they had the whole intermission between the first and second quarters to decide they're going to challenge the first down spot. First quarter ended with a first down, so signaled. Here comes
after
the call.
After review, the ruling on the field stands. Baltimore is charged with their first team timeout.
Well, the runner is stopped. Take a look again, and there's nothing that we saw in all of the replays we were watching during the break here that would allow the crew to overturn it. He's still moving. The ball gets obscured. The nose of the ball just had to reach the front edge of the 30-yard line because that series had started after the touchback, and there's nothing there to indicate that the ball didn't get there. Line judge came in, makes the call. Call stands. First down to the 30.
It's a heck of a play by Heath Miller, too. If he doesn't push Moore forward, he doesn't make it.
Now the pistol formation again. Roethlisberger's used it about a half dozen times tonight. And Mendenhall gets taken down immediately. And that's DeJuan Landry, who sustained a concussion last week in the Tampa game. And they had to keep an eye on him. And he had to pass the test this week to enable him to play tonight.
Well, you can tell the Pittsburgh Steelers and offensive coordinator Bruce Arians, they're just trying to get a few plays to get the ball out of Ben Roethlisberger's hands. Because right now, this offensive line of the Steelers has been no match across the board for the Ravens' defensive line.
Second down and 10. And Ben will go down. Tried to get it away at the last instant, couldn't. And that is Suggs coming in for the sack.
Good patience by Terrell Suggs on that one. He's going to loop back inside here, but he just sort of danced in front of Jonathan Scott, biding his time, and then came up with a huge sack. Right now, Terrell Suggs, who has more sacks of Roethlisberger than anybody, is making his presence known. And down the field, the reason that Ben had to hold it was that.
AFC Defensive Player of the Month of November gets off to a good start. In December, here's Redmond back in the game. He was hurt on the first series, and they give it to him, and Redmond gets out past the 30 to the 32-yard line. Started to break away, and then Ed Reed comes up to stop him while shy of the first down.
You know, anytime you see a Steelers run, usually Hines Ward has something to do with it. They bring Hines Ward down so many times, and he makes those key blocks in there, and I just don't think that they are expecting to see Isaac Redmond run the football out of any formation.
Darius Webb is back to receive the Daniel Sepulveda kick. Webb from the 15-yard line. Gets around the corner. Webb out past the 40 and gets banged down up at the 49-yard line by Arnez Battle. Good run back. Ravens will have it at midfield 2 minutes into the second quarter. 7-0, Baltimore. Sunday Night Football brought to you by Verizon. The signal is yours. Verizon rule the air. By Citizen, fueled by Light, it never needs a battery. Unstoppable. By your local Lexus dealer. And by Bud Light, it's the sure sign of a good time. Here we go. Well, they played four high school championship games in this stadium over the weekend. Dunbar winning the 1A title. McDonough, Wild Lake, and Urbana, the other state champions. Football weekend in Baltimore, M&T Bank Stadium has been the scene of all of the action, and it concludes tonight with the Steelers and the Ravens. First down from the 49-yard line as Flacco guns one incomplete, and the crowd wants a flag, and so does Derek Mason. He's covered by Brian McFadden.
Well, so far, it's been Joe Flacco looking more like Ben Roethlisberger than Ben Roethlisberger. Watch him just buying time and giving Anquan Boldin time to find an opening, and it was Brian McFadden who had man under coverage. He should be looking at Boldin the entire time, no matter what. He flips his head to look back at Flacco. Boldin uncovers. Easy touchdown.
Ravens' last drive, longest TD drive against the Steelers in the history of this franchise, and the pass is incomplete, intended for Dennis Pitta. Pitta, one of the two tight ends we talked about heaping out of the game after one play. Pitta, a rookie, and Ed Dixon, the other.
Yeah, and the reason they drafted these two rookies this year was because of the 34 defense that they had to face in the Pittsburgh Steelers. They knew they had to sort of extend out those blocking schemes.
There is Daniel Sepulveda, the left-footed kicker, and they're checking his right leg. He had that 53-yard boot, but a 35-yard return to set Baltimore up here at the 49-yard line. Third and 10, and here they come. The Flacco stays in there, and the pass is caught, but about 3 yards short of the first down. Derek Mason, who caught 8 balls last week and was targeted 13 times, is stopped. It'll be fourth down and 3.
Nice job by Ray Rice. He's going to pick up Timmons off the edge here. I'll tell you, when you play Pittsburgh, the most important part of a running back's job is figuring out who's blitzing first and then getting them blocked second.
And there's Mason. So they're already minus heat for the rest of the game. And there is Derek Mason, who's done such yeoman work. 14 years in the league. Started his career with the Tennessee Titans, played in the Super Bowl with them against St. Louis after the 99 season. And he's been a stalwart here in Baltimore.
And I tell you, Mike Tomlin, when he was talking about the receivers of the Baltimore Ravens, he wasn't concerned about anybody as much as he was Derek Mason.
And McFadden gets him, and then over the top goes Harrison. And so now Mason comes limping back to the sideline. Then it will be fourth down and 3. Sam Cook to do the punting. Cook's third punt is bouncing at the 5-yard line, and then it bounces into the end zone. But it's Marcus Smith, who had a chance to down it but couldn't. Out it comes to the 20 when we come back. Tomorrow night, Jay Leno will be welcoming Russell Brand, and then as the week goes on, Jeff Bridges, Terry Bradshaw, Halle Berry. Terry spending more time with Jay than he is with Menifee, Johnson, Strahan, and Long.
That's because he's good. He's funny
on
that
great show. Tonight's show with Jay Leno all week on NBC. From the 20, first down, Steelers. Ben, clean pocket, and rifles the pass, and that is caught, and bowling ball is in his way out to the 45-yard line is David Johnson, who is 6'2 and 260, drafted in the seventh round last year. Can play a lot of spots in the offensive sets, 25 yards.
Without question, the best protection of the night for the Pittsburgh Steelers. Five rushers, five offensive linemen, all of them blocked, and if you get that done, you come up with big plays.
And so much for that bad foot and the bloody nose as he guns one over the middle for a gain of 25, and now he hands the ball off to Mendenhall, and Mendenhall goes absolutely nowhere, and there is Ray Lewis making his presence felt for the first time tonight. Ray Lewis, 15th season, one of the original Ravens, a team starting here in 96, two-time defensive player of the year. 30 or more sacks or interceptions, one of two players since 1982. And the Ravens have allowed under 4 yards per rush in every season since they came here and began the franchise as the Baltimore Ravens after moving from Cleveland following the 95 campaign. Second and 10. And that pass is caught, and it's close to a first down for Antonio Brown. And that other player we should mention who fits into that category with the 30 sacks and interceptions would be, of course, our own Roddy Harrison back in the studio.
Not bad at all. But I tell you, the thing that impresses me so much about Ray Lewis is he's about what's good for the team. He tells Joe Flacco, do what you do. Don't worry about turning the football over. So far this season, the Ravens defense has not allowed a touchdown off a turnover. It's an amazing statistic.
From the 45, indeed, as the play fake to Mendenhall, and then Ben is going to roll, and Ben is going to throw this one away. And that is incredible when you think about it. Yeah, normally, because turnovers are such killers, but that Raven defense, every time this season that the offense has turned it over, they've at least limited the opposition to a field goal at worst.
Yeah, and because you got guys like Terrell Suggs who can do this. I mean, Flo Zell is just, there's no way that physically he can keep up with the speed of Terrell Suggs. Terrell Suggs on both sides now completely wearing out these Pittsburgh Steeler tackles.
10 minutes to the half, 7-0 Ravens. Second and 10. Four receivers on the right side. The pump fake by Roethlisberger. Going deep, and it's going to get picked off at the 5-yard line. Intercepted by Josh Wilson, acquired just before the season from Seattle. Intended for Antonio Brown. Forward progress takes him into the end zone, but they're going to spot the ball at the 2-yard line. Interception by Josh Wilson. It was a second down and 10. They picked him up in a trade. They'd lost Dominique Foxworth, one of their starting corners, and then Wilson came over from Seattle at the outset of the season.
And that was a huge trade. Fabian Washington did not work out either. And Josh Wilson's been getting the job done.
The 2-yard line, and this is Flacco trying to buy some space here, and he gets 2 yards out to the 4.
Well, Antonio Brown is going to do the job here on the release, but he also is going to fool Dewan Landry. Little out, up, but Josh Wilson never breaks stride. He just stays right with that throw, and the pump fake didn't affect him at all, and he comes up with just a huge play for this defense. But if the Pittsburgh Steelers can convert on the defensive end and pin him down inside the 10, that play wouldn't be such a huge negative for the Steelers.
And despite the momentum of Wilson, you might be wondering, his momentum was taking him into the end zone. He wasn't trying to run it back. He's like a receiver at that point. It's where he has possession of the ball. Willis McGahee comes out to the 6-yard line. In the commercial break, and Harbaugh was talking to the officials about, hey, you know, his momentum took him into the end zone, but that doesn't matter in that particular case.
That's exactly right. My man James Harrison's starting to get a little fired up here now. You're going to bring over a rookie tight end, and two of them, and try and play me? Good luck. Holding and everything, doesn't matter. Look how low James Harrison gets and just explodes into Dixon.
Third down and 6. Dante Stallworth is in the game for the Ravens. And there's a deep pass for Stallworth. And Stallworth across the 50. Inside the 40 and finally taken down at the 27-yard line. Stallworth suspended all of last year. Broken foot earlier this season. Comes into the game and immediately with a huge play, 67 yards.
Ryan McFadden's having a bad game tonight. Watch him right out here. He's going to try and make a play on the slot receiver. He comes off his guy and leaves the fastest guy on the Ravens team completely alone. Great read by Joe Flacco. Bryant McFadden gave up the game-winning touchdown the first time these two teams met, and so far tonight he's been terrible.
Second charge timeout, Baltimore, 30-second timeout.
And one reason you see Stallworth in the game is because Mason had gotten hurt. So Stallworth involved in that accident in Florida where a man was killed. And he was suspended all of last season. Ravens upgrading their receiver core this year, went out and they got Bolden, signed Stallworth. And of course they drafted the two rookie tight ends and they picked up Hushman Zada as well. And there is Dan Rooney, the U.S. ambassador to Ireland. So Dan has come over from time to time during the past two seasons. And of course when they meet the Ravens, he wants to be here. But so far it's been tough. 7-0 Baltimore on top. And Bart Rooney the second, Pittsburgh Brain Trust, looking on right now. But the Ravens with 184 total yards to 67 for Pittsburgh and driving again. Hushman Zada gets tackled by McFadden after a minimal gain.
Well, they're definitely going after Brian McFadden, who came into this game with a bad hamstring, so it's understandable. But those are big tackles on the outside. The Steelers brought both inside linebackers. So if McFadden doesn't make that tackle, there's going to be plenty of space to work out there. He did make a nice play there.
So far, a comparison. That 179 yards, Flacco with big plays to Bolden and Stallworth. And a touchdown pass to Bolden. 2nd and 9. And a whistle before the snap.
False start. Offense number 74. 5-yard penalty. 2nd down.
Michael Orr, that's already 7 penalties. Michael Orr last week sprained his knee, tweeted during the game, and that cost him $5,000.
I tell you, when I was watching the tape, I was really trying to slow it down to see if Michael Orr was jumping off sides during the course of the week. But Michael Orr with that bad knee, you can tell he's trying to cheat it a little bit. And these officials are calling it really tightly, but I think accurately.
Well, Ocho Cinco got fined $25,000, Orr only $5,000. Winds up on WikiLeaks, it's $10,000.
But he made a movie.
2nd and 14. Wow. And Rice can't get out of the backfield because James Harrison is there. Mike Tomlin last night talking about Harrison and saying, you know what, because he's been the man in the crosshairs with all of the fines this year, it'll probably cost him Defensive Player of the Year.
Dante Stallworth, the wide receiver, had the job of trying to crack him along with Anquan Bolden. Instead, James Harrison cracked both of them and Ray Rice.
Anyway, that was Tomlin's opinion of the season Harrison is having. He says all of the stuff is getting overlooked.
Well, the player of the month, I could make a pretty strong case that it should have been Harrison.
3rd and 15, and here come the Steelers. Ike Taylor on the corner blitz getting in there.
Well, the problem is if you back up as a quarterback, you're going to get pressure off the edge. And if you back up, you're going to get it. Ray Rice here is really doing a good job. He's going to push. Who's that? Lawrence Timmons, I'm sorry, around the pocket. But when Flacco decided to back up to try and escape, basically he made it easy on Timmons.
Sam Cook punting. And you've got Antoine Randall L. right now back at his own 10-yard line. High floater toward the sideline. Randall L. with the catch at the 15-yard line. 5.5 to go in the half. 7-0, Baltimore. AFC North, each of these teams 8-3. But this is a more important game for the Steelers to win, because if Baltimore wins, they'd be a game in front, plus they'd have swept the season series.
Well, that's why they're playing like this. These two teams just getting after it right now. And Al, I have to say that so far, it looks like the Steelers' offensive line getting a bit exposed. There were question marks across the board. Physically, could they hold up without Ben being able to scramble and make plays? And so far tonight, the answer is no. Almost 70 yards of offense is all it is for the Pittsburgh Steelers so far.
67 precisely on 20 plays. And Mendenhall will pick up three out to the 23.
Well, they tell us Ben's nose isn't broken, but most noses that are, they don't do like that. I don't know. I'm not a doctor, you know. I'm just saying.
We just play one, right?
Yeah.
With the blood on his jersey, as we talked to John Harbaugh earlier this week. He said, hey, I'm not a doctor, but I just play one every week in the press conference.
Ben might need two next week.
2nd and 7. And that pass is a little under throw, but Wallace comes back. And he's able to make the catch for a first down at the 35-yard line.
Well, okay, Josh Wilson, you're going to try and attack? Go ahead. We're going to run in our fastest guy up here at you. Josh Wilson said, I'm not stupid. That guy runs 4.28. I'm getting out of here. You can make that completion. Go on with it.
Wallace's first catch. Hines Ward has not caught a ball tonight. Ward wide to the right, Wallace in the slot, and now Ward comes into the slot inside Wallace on 1st and 10. And Ben scrambles away and then throws it away. 2nd down.
You know, the Baltimore Ravens defensively in their secondary, they've just been all over these receivers down the field. Darius Webb on the other side against the speedy Wallace. And then Hines Ward working inside, going against Chris Carr, and he's covered. Ordinarily, when Ben makes one guy escape or one guy miss, he comes up with those big plays down the field, but there was nowhere to go.
2nd and 10. And Ben throws, and that will be caught, and that's going to be a first down, and that is the rookie out of SMU, Emmanuel Sanders.
Well, they've found a little soft spot now. They're going to go check out Josh Wilson and see whether or not he can hold up for a whole game in one-on-one coverage, because that right now that's what he's being asked to do.
Ben's foot, I mean, it was the big story coming in. Seems to be fine. Then we didn't know if he'd be back with the second series after the bloody nose. He looks like Ben.
Fine, but not the mobility we're used to seeing.
Right.
And not the creative plays we're used to seeing out of that mobility.
And as you said, too, the offensive line needs to be better. Here's Mendenhall breaking through. And Mendenhall across the 50 to the 46-yard line, tackled by Landry.
And this is what I think that the Pittsburgh Steelers need to get back to here. Because this is a football team in Baltimore. They are not producing the same way on the against the run that they do typically. There's Antoine Randall-El working down the field. But runs have been had against this Ravens defense this year, but they really have not focused on it very much to this point in the game.
2nd and 2. And that pass is incomplete. Mendenhall stopped, tried to dump it off to him. Suggs was right there anyway. It'll be 3rd down and 2.
Yeah, in the league, this is called a business decision. When you come out and you're looking at Terrell Suggs and it's a little out in front of you, my agent said don't go for that.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Classic. I hear footsteps.
And they're big. Suggs got a little bloody lip too.
And looming. 3rd down and 2, and then
first charge timeout.
They will take a timeout.
30-second timeout.
Third down and two. Pittsburgh taking a timeout. What's going to be interesting, too, here is if they don't get the first down and have to punt. We saw Sepulveda, and they were working on his right leg, the plant leg, before. Can he punt is the question. There he is hobbling on the sideline. Sean Sweezum, the field goal kicker, had been practicing punts on the sideline.
And the Ravens' defense has not been very good in short yardage this year.
Third and a short two. And this is Redmond, and he's going to lose the ball. Can Mendenhall recover for Pittsburgh is the question. He was right there. Redmond losing the football. And they had Mendenhall in the lineup with him as well on third down, and he is able to save it, save possession for Pittsburgh, and that's going to probably take us to the two-minute warning.
What a play by Jarrett Johnson on that one.
Whew. So fourth and two when we come back in the battle for first in the AFC North with Baltimore up 7-0. Steelers, with 2 minutes to go in the half, will line up to go for it at the 44-yard line. Fourth down and two. It was Marquise Pouncey, the rookie center, who actually recovered that last fumble. There's Sepulveda, and they taped him up. We're told from his groin down to his calf, so the chances of him playing the rest of the night are minimal. And they go for it on fourth and two, and the pass is caught, and they're going to pick up the first down as the catch is made by David Johnson, his second reception. That moves the chains, first down at the 39-yard line.
Boy, a lot of action being created by the backside receivers allowed David Johnson to come across the formation there. Probably won't be officially called a pick, but that's exactly what it was. Backside receivers picked off everybody in coverage. Big first down.
Steelers with two timeouts. And Roethlisberger to the right side and incomplete as the pass is thrown. Emmanuel Sanders way got behind the initial coverage and then been throwing it out of bounds. It'll be second down and 10.
It was really a good job by Ben Roethlisberger. They tried one of those out and up kind of moves on the outside. Unfortunately, he had the wrong safety coverage. So the safety hanging right there would have intercepted that ball. Ben saw it, just threw it away.
Ward and Wallace go left. Moore is in the backfield. Sanders, the rookie, to the right side. Second and 10. Look at that time for Roethlisberger, and the pass is incomplete. It was Sanders going across the formation, deep down the field. Chris Carr covering on the play, third down and 10.
Lodi Nada now playing over Marquise Pouncey right here in the middle. They felt like Pouncey was a great athlete for a rookie. They didn't know how well he would hold up against Lodi Nada. I'd say pretty darn well right there. That protection was as good as you could get.
So Suggs started to come in, and then he backed off to go into coverage against the tight end Miller. Third down and 10. Six defensive backs in for Baltimore. Again, a lot of time for Ben, and then the pass is dropped. So Ward targeted for the first time tonight. Can't collect it, fourth down.
Boy, I tell you, what a job they did in protection, and Hines Ward blew it. How many times have you ever seen that? Here goes Hines right here. This protection is awesome. They brought all the heat off the left side. Isaac Redmond makes a great block, good adjustment, right between the 8 and the 6. Unbelievable.
And now Sweezum, who is their place kicker, has to come into punt because of the injury to Sepulveda. He punted three times as a Redskin last season. And the kick bounces at the 6. There's a flag on the play, and the ball is down at the 2-yard line. But the penalty is going to be against Pittsburgh.
Holding prior to the kick. Offense number 97. 10-yard penalty, fourth down.
Have to do it again instead of having the ball down to the 2. Cowboys knocking off the Colts in overtime. One of the subjects on the Toyota halftime show. The Raiders knock off San Diego after San Diego looked so great last week against Indianapolis. Giants beat the Skins, keep pace with the Eagles in the NFC East, coming up on the Toyota halftime show from 30 Rock, which you saw in that shot. A holding call against Jason Worlds. And Sweezen to have to kick again. So against Sepulveda with that right leg tape. Sweezen signed 3 weeks ago. Ladarius Webb is back this time to return the kick. And Webb collects it and then drops it at the 11-yard line and gets taken to the ground at the 15-yard line. So Baltimore with 46 seconds, and they have one timeout.
There's a dough.
Sweezen sitting on his couch 3 weeks ago, and all of a sudden he's the field goal kicker, the punter.
And a lot of purple coming after him. You know, Sepulveda, this is not the first issue he's had with his non-kicking leg. It happened to him in college. He's had two different issues with that knee. And so now they are in a bit of a spot in a game that has a lot of punting as part of it. Been a really good first half, though. I hope people can appreciate how good this defense has been, really, on both sides of the ball. That helmet all scarred up.
From the 15-yard line on first down, and they'll be content to go into the locker room with a 7-point advantage as Willis McGahee picks up a hard yard.
And the really good news for the Pittsburgh Steelers is that Brett Keisel has survived the half. I talked to him a little bit before the game, and he just didn't know. He said, I don't know what's going to happen out here. The last time I tried to push it, I pulled my hamstring again a little bit, but he has survived, and I think he's been in on every snap, and they really feel like he could be a difference maker for them.
Missing Keisel, of course, Aaron Smith's been out since early in the year. Haven't put him on IR. Hope to have him back before the end of the season. And that will take us to halftime with a Flacco kneel down. End of the first half in Baltimore, where the Ravens lead the Steelers 7-0. Coming up next, the Toyota halftime show. But first, these messages from your local NBC station.
Let's leave our legacy, man. Let's leave it tonight. 60 minutes of football. Everything we got. 1, 2, 3. Woo!
Wide open for the touchdown is Anquan Boldin.
Get up, get up, get up, get up, time to fly.
And that is Suggs coming in for the sack.
Terrell Suggs, who has more sacks of Roethlisberger than anybody, is making his presence known.
Going deep, and it's going to get picked off at the 5-yard line. Intercepted by Josh Wilson. Battle for first place, AFC North. Baltimore leading 7-0 as we start the second half. You can keep your head in the game with NFL Mobile, only from Verizon, the official wireless service provider of the National Football League. Hal Michaels, Chris Collinsworth, Andrea Kramer, M&T Bank Stadium, downtown Baltimore on this 34 degrees Sunday night. The Pittsburgh Steelers, who won the toss and deferred, will get the second half kickoff as Billy Cundiff will send it down to the rookie Antonio Brown.
Now, doesn't it feel like the Steelers could run the ball a little more than what they are? I mean, they're having trouble in their pass blocking, but they have had success running the ball tonight as opposed to the Ravens, who have had no success running the ball.
Mendenhall, you're right, has carried 8 times for 27, and Redmond 2 for 12, and Cundiff with another touchback. He's on his way to setting a record for touchbacks. Meanwhile, let's go down to the sideline and check in with Andrea Kramer. Andrea.
Well, Al, Mike Tomlin acknowledged his offense isn't playing well. He said no major adjustments. The main thing they have to do is catch balls on third down. Now, when the team just came out for the second half, Tomlin walked over to the offensive line. He was exhorting them to do better. As for the punting situation, he thought Sweezen would continue to punt, but he expected Daniel Sepulveda to hold for place kicks.
So Sweezen punted at the end of the first half. Meanwhile, for the Ravens on their side, Derek Mason came out of the game, and the Ravens are telling us nothing about his condition. And Todd Heap, of course, is out of the game after the first play of the game, the tight end. On first down, they give it to Mendenhall. He's out to the 25-yard line. It'll be second down and five.
Well, the first half really dominated by the Ravens defense and their studs. Ray Lewis was fantastic. Terrell Suggs, completely dominant. And Haloti Ngata with a big hello to Ben Roethlisberger there.
The big Haloti.
Yeah.
Oh, come on. I didn't say that, did I?
The one person we haven't heard that much from so far, though, is Ed Reed. And if Ben wants to start taking some shots and gets impatient, we probably will.
At the 50 career interceptions, they swing it out. And this is Mendenhall making the catch. Tackled by Gooden. Remember, the game starts, and the big storyline is Ben Roethlisberger in the walking boot all week. The specially designed shoe. That shoe is 1.5 sizes larger than it would normally be. And the bloody nose on the first series, and yet here he is, 10 out of 20 for 101 yards. And he's been lining up in this formation, known as the pistol in college football, a short shotgun. He's done it about 10 times tonight. And over the middle, the pass is caught up at the 47-yard line, and finally, Hines Ward makes a catch. His first catch of the night. He's covered downfield by Ray Lewis.
Well, there's Hines Ward making a catch, and one of the reasons why they've been sacrificing Heath Miller right over here to help against Terrell Suggs. Well, Suggs says, fine, you're going to help on me. I'm just going to make sure you don't get down in the route, so eliminate him. But this time, the catch was made.
From the 47 on first down. Quick flip. Wallace gets by Landry. And Wallace to the 29-yard line. So the speedy one makes the catch and then is able to take off and goes downfield for 23 yards.
What a great read that time by Roethlisberger. Look what happens here. They're going to come up like this. So there's nothing going on. Landry, I think, was trying to play games and make it look like a blitz. But here's Mike Wallace, one of the great big play receivers in the game today. Whew, he is quick.
From the 30-yard line, back to the ground, to Mendenhall. And the defense stopping with the line of scrimmage, Jameel McLean in on the tackle.
Well, they just can't handle Terrell Suggs. I mean, they've got everything else going. Watch it here on the outside. Jonathan Scott's a pretty quick player, but basically Suggs just takes Jonathan Scott and throws him right into the running back. Marquise Pouncey, the center, is going to come off, and he had Ray Lewis, so they had a decent-looking play going. They just couldn't block Suggs.
Second and 10. Mendenhall over the left side this time, taken down hard at the 27-yard line. The Steelers, interestingly, this season, in the third quarter, total, they've scored 16 points. In 11 games, they have one third-quarter touchdown that came against Cleveland. The Ravens, meanwhile, have allowed only 12 third-quarter points.
Look at all the stuff on the left-hand side, but Terrell Suggs goes to the weak side of the formation. So no matter how hard the Steelers are trying to block him, he keeps going to the weak side, and they don't have blockers on that side. So he ends up in those one-on-ones.
Dime defense for the Ravens on third down and 7. Blitz, here they come. Roethlisberger hangs in there, and the pass is incomplete. The rookie Sanders can't make the catch. Wilson with the coverage. It'll be fourth down and 7. At the 27-yard line, here comes the field goal unit. Sepulveda will do the holding now at the 35-yard line. So a 45-yard attempt for Sweezum, signed 3 weeks ago, to replace Jeff Reed. And he kicked 4 from 40-plus last week to beat Buffalo. And now Sepulveda is going to take a timeout.
Oh, boy.
Pittsburgh,
30-second
timeout.
Pretty interesting. His timeouts in the second half are golden.
Yeah, and I tell you, that play was set up, and the reason they're having to try this field goal basically another third down drop by the receivers. We have seen that plenty so far in this game. And when you're playing a defense like the Ravens and your quarterback is bloodied and trying to fight his way through it, it's not good.
Well, whatever Tomlin saw, Tomlin's the guy who calls the timeout.
I would guess it had to be the clock.
Either that or he didn't have 11 guys on the field. Yard attempt. And Sweezen is good.
Really good.
Yeah, his Pittsburgh career is off to a big start. Steelers on the board, 7-3, Ravens. James Harrison has been in the crosshairs, of course, with the implementation of the rules and the fines, and Harrison, $125,000. James Farrier came out in support of him. A lot of you read about the remarks made by Heinz Ward. And when you make the cover of Sports Illustrated, that's the $75,000 fine. And he was fined $5,000 for that hit on Vince Young. And here's the one in Cleveland that wound up on the cover of SI. And then that one against Drew Brees in the Sunday Nighter in New Orleans. Last week, Ryan Fitzpatrick goes down. And there's your buck and a quarter.
Went fast, didn't it?
Yes.
Those guys are not happy about it.
Kickoff fielded at the 10-yard line by David Reed. And Reed gets it back out to the 34-yard line.
And Al, I think part of the frustration on the part of the Steelers is, what is a foul these days? Watch these two hits. This one first on Jason Campbell. Looks a lot like that one on Ryan Fitzpatrick. The one on Jason Campbell, that should not have been a foul. James Harrison tried to slide his helmet past Jason Campbell. This one's textbook. Any part of the helmet that hits any part of a defenseless player is a foul in this league, and they are going to find it.
Here's Flacco on first down, and the pass is incomplete, and the crowd wants a flag. McFadden covering Bolden on the play. No penalty.
Going back again, right where they left off, to Brian McFadden, and this is a good read, one-on-one. This time Anquan Bolden really just kind of took off, really didn't set up Brian McFadden very well on that one. Thought it was clean.
You know, there's a lot of confusion and some mystery as to exactly what will get you fined these days. Second and 10. Some are obvious, some not so obvious. Here's Rice, and he's going to cut it back, and Rice gets taken down by Polamalu, but not until he picks up a first down. You know, Chris, in a way, I'm not simplifying this, but if you lead with your helmet, there's a good chance you're going to get fined.
A defenseless player, defenseless receiver, defenseless quarterback. If that helmet strikes the defenseless player, it's a foul. It doesn't matter if he hits him in the thigh. If he's a defenseless player, it's a foul.
First and 10, the ball is at the 45. A hard play fake, avoids a sack, gets it away as he gets hit as he throws, and that was James Harrison coming in and making contact as Flacco got it off. Second down to 10.
I'll tell you what, they are asking a lot of Ed Dixon, a rookie tight end, trying to block James Harrison on the outside. You don't want to make your living doing this. I thought he might have even held him there. Got just enough of a push. I wouldn't push my luck too much with that blocking combination.
Derek Mason is now back in the game. He was shaken up in the first half. Flacco on second and 10. And that pass is incomplete. Good coverage by Taylor that time. Working on Ed Dixon, third down and 10.
To me, that's a really strange throw. I mean, ordinarily, if you get Dixon or a tight end out there and they flank Ryan Clark or a safety, you go, okay, hey, I'm going to take my shot here. You go out there against the best cover guy that the Steelers have, and Ike Taylor, you go somewhere else. There's just no reason to go here.
And they went 3-by-1 with the three big guys on the right side. Figured they'd sneak one to the left side.
I think Dixon was as surprised as anybody.
Not against Ike Taylor from Swaggin. Third and 10. And that is caught by Mason. And again, they go to work on McFadden with success.
When you talk to Mike Tomlin, he said if the Ravens have big drives, they'll have at least one 20-yard throw typically to Derek Mason down the field. Again, working against McFadden, pretty throw. And James Harrison this time from the stand-up position took Marshall Yanda and just drove him into the ground. But Yanda provided enough time to get it off.
First down, 39. Rice with 3 yards to the 36-yard line. Polk makes a stop.
Well, you can see that the Ravens, and I think justifiably so now, are going to try and establish a run that they could not establish in the first half. And you say, wow, you're playing against the Pittsburgh Steelers. It's the best run defense in all the NFL. Well, the reason you do it is so that you can go to the play action that Joe Flacco has been using so effectively this year.
Second and 7. Short drop. Hip throw. Usman Zada could have a first down. Tackled to the 28-yard line.
Ray Rice is doing a fantastic job with this. Look at the defense. Not a single guy with his hand on the ground. And so now Ray Rice has to try and figure out who the free rusher is. There he is. Lawrence Timmons. Pick him up. Beautiful.
Get to the line in a hurry to the Ravens. And Rice takes the ball to the 25-yard line. Rice tonight as a runner. 6 attempts, 23 yards.
And remember, Ray Rice was available in the first Pittsburgh game, but he was a non-factor. But he's also the last guy that's rushed for over 100 yards against the Steelers in the last 45 games.
214 for Baltimore, 167. Total yardage for Pittsburgh, second down and 7. Flacco breaking away. He's going to run. First down inside the 15th, flag down. Taken down to the 10-yard line. Flag on the near side of the field, away from the play.
Illegal contact. Defense number 24. 5-yard penalty to be added to the end of the run. First down.
Mike Taylor on the other side of the field. First down.
Mike Taylor well down the field working against TJ Houshmandzadeh. There it is, the shot to the face, and it was down the field. But I tell you, Joe Flacco's mobility tonight has been the difference. Who would have believed in a game between Ben Roethlisberger and Joe Flacco that would have been the mobility of Flacco that really has been the deciding factor?
He is really coming of age.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
First and goal of all is at the 6-yard line. And Flacco throwing a fade, and the pass is incomplete, intended for Bolden. Polamalu blitzing on the play. Second and goal.
Yeah, and that time Ray Rice either went the wrong way or just didn't see it. Nice job by Flacco. Just get it out of there. Troy Polamalu coming off this edge right here is going to come in unblocked. And Flacco sees it just in time to throw it away.
Second and goal. Ravens spread it out. And Flacco throws a fade to the other corner of the end zone and incomplete. Intended for the rookie Addiction, covered by the safety Ryan Clark. Third and goal.
Yeah, but this is the one you do take the shots. You've got the safety Ryan Clark out there. The problem is that, like a lot of young receivers, Dixon doesn't squeeze it inside enough, so really Flacco has very little ground on the outside of the end zone to try and get that one in there. Big tight end, go in there and just blow up Ryan Clark and then do a little fade, and you'll have a lot of green grass or whatever that stuff is out there.
Ursa Express. Third and goal. And Flacco in trouble, avoiding the sack, and dumps it off, and it's incomplete, so he's able to avoid a vice. Woodley and Brett Kiesel seem to have him corralled, and that's going to set up a short field goal attempt.
You know, Lamar Woodley coming right around the edge here. Again, a tight end and a back trying to block one of the premier pass rushers in the game. But we have seen so far what the Ravens' plan has been, is they are trying to take away James Harrison, and they're taking some chances with Lamar Woodley.
Billy Cundiff signed a year ago, and he won the game in overtime here between these two teams. 24-yard attempt. Cook to hold. And the lead goes back to 7. With 7:13 remaining in the third quarter, Baltimore 10, Pittsburgh 3. And the battle for first place in the AFC North. Going to go into a mark of 9-3. Pittsburgh from the 20-yard line now. Roethlisberger hits the tight end Miller. That's a gain of 9 yards, taken down by Carr, setting up a second down and 1.
Looks like they're going a little hurry up now too. And really, Al, the difference in this game to me so far has been the two drops on third down. In a one touchdown game, those plays make a huge difference.
The missed opportunities are down by 7. Second down and 1 from the 29-yard line. Rashard Mendenhall tries to go to his left. And that's a loss of 3 yards. Jared Johnson, the linebacker, stopping him. Third down and 3.
I tell you, I talked to Greg Madison, and he said, I think if you took a vote of our players, they may well tell you that Jared Johnson is the MVP of this defense. Look how disciplined he is. Rashard Mendenhall is one of the fastest backs in the league. He just holds his ground, completely under control, made a huge stop earlier. He's playing a big game.
Here in the league, one of the reasons he doesn't get that notice, you're a linebacker on the same team with Lewis and Suggs. Moeldy Moore is the back on 3rd and 3. And Ben Johnson loses the ball. It's loose, and picking it up and saving it at the 11-yard line is Chris Timoyaki, and he brings it back out to the 20-yard line. And he takes a shot. It was Suggs who came in and creates the sack, and Roethlisberger.
Holding, defense number 43.
Whoa.
Uh-oh.
5-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
Haruki Nakamura.
Oh, boy, you just cannot grab the jersey. Watch and see if he doesn't grab. There you go. And the thing that I think young defenders sometimes forget is there's official watching every eligible receiver. And I wish somebody were watching Terrell Suggs, because he is killing the Pittsburgh Steelers. King Watu looked like a big old fullback, but he took a shot like one, too.
And Nakamura, 5'10", 195, doing everything he could to stop the 6'5", 256-pound Miller. First and 10 at the 33-yard line. Three-man rush. Dump off to Mendenhall. And Mendenhall breaking tackles and gets 9. Broke away from Jared Johnson. Stopped just short of the 43-yard line.
Well, Ben standing in the pocket tall. Ordinarily on a play like this, you might see him take off, but he just dumps it off to Mendenhall. I tell you, Mendenhall is coming off of one of the best games I've seen him have against Buffalo. A career high, a lifetime high carries, 36 in that game. You wondered how he bounced back, but he's been good here tonight.
Second and 1, Mendenhall. And fights his way for a first down at the 46-yard line. Landry comes up to make the tackle with 4:40 left in the quarter.
Ben Roethlisberger's footwork is starting to look better. I don't know if it's loosening up a little bit or what, but that kind of looked like a normal drop back to me. So maybe we can see some of the old Ben Roethlisberger now.
46-yard line. First down. Again, rushing only 3. And that pass is caught across the 50-yard line by the rookie Sanders. He's tackled by Josh Wilson.
Well, the Steelers that time go to the empty backfield. They're going to spread out some of these big guys that they're having trouble blocking. And that was the ball that Sanders had dropped earlier on third down. This time he made the play.
Steelers going up tempo, and it's a good drive to this point. Second and 1. Ball again, and this time he'll get stuffed by Lewis. Ray Lewis. Greg Madison, the defensive coordinator. I mean, it's as good a compliment as anybody can get. I mean, we don't all know about Lewis. He's going to go into the Hall of Fame. He said he watches film like a coach and he listens like a rookie.
And he hits like a tank.
Right.
Yeah.
He's only done it for 15 seasons. Third and one. Redmond is in the backfield. Give it to him. Stopped in his tracks. Fourth down. DeJuan Landry came barreling through.
Cannot block Terrell Suggs.
And now they're going to go quick on fourth down. Roethlisberger is going to line him up before any switches can be made defensively. And Ben's going to say, I got them to jump offside. Corey Redding came across the line. Terry McCauley to give us the call.
Unbelievable.
Who moved first, Adams or Redding?
Neutral zone infraction, defense. 5-yard penalty, first down.
Redding.
Everything was a bit unsettled. I think that I couldn't tell, did the ball come out on that last play? It's almost like they were going to the hurry up to try and cover up something or catch them without being able to substitute. I'm not sure, but whatever it was, it worked big.
It worked big time, first and 10. At the 40-yard line. And now Ben with a deep drop. Buying time, extending the play as he has been doing for years, and that pass is incomplete, and Miller really takes a shot.
And that's helmet to helmet. You could hear it up here, I think.
Right.
I mean, everybody knows that sound.
And you saw the Ravens waving immediately to the Pittsburgh bench to get help out there. Miller down. Well, they have kept Miller immobile, and that's the first time he's attempted to move his head, but they've got him down there at the 30-yard line. And back again, it's McClain, the linebacker, who comes in helmet to helmet here.
Well, even if it's not helmet to helmet, it's a defenseless player. Shoulder pad, forearm, or helmet to the head is an automatic penalty. And to get, I didn't see a flag. If there is one, it's buried down there, is unbelievable to me. But that was not called. That is by the very definition of what I've been told. Defenseless player, either the helmet, the shoulder pad, or the forearm to the head, that is a foul, and that's the second one tonight that has not been called on the Baltimore Ravens. And I'm sure the Steelers fans are going, what the heck?
And that's great, because when the guy's down as long as Miller was, and then to be able to get up and walk off under his own power, Pittsburgh tight end heads over to the bench. And again, you're right, Chris, but it's one of those things where the receiver starts to duck down. The guy's coming in, the defender. And you're gonna have situations like that. I mean, no matter what the rules are.
Tell that to James Harrison and his $125,000 worth of fines.
I'm with you on that.
That's amazing that was not called.
Matt Spaeth, another tight end, is inactive tonight. So they're down to David Johnson, and they line him up in the backfield. And then send him into the slot on second down and 10. And the pass is caught out of the flat by Antonio Brown. And they run Brown out at about the 29-yard line. And that's a first down, 11-yard gain.
You know, Antonio Brown is basically getting his chance because he's a kick returner. And they thought that Emmanuel Sanders had kind of gotten a little weary of that role. So they made the switch. He's made a few plays for them.
Roethlisberger right now 16 of 28 for 175 yards. This drive where they picked up the tempo. Sees Mendenhall go to the 26, and the two big plays on this drive were the two penalties against the Ravens defense. And for Mendenhall, that puts him up and over 1,000 yards this season.
I'll tell you, Heath Miller is such a huge part of this offense. It is going to be a tough guy to replace, and they're already without Matt Spaeth, the other tight end, so they are down to one tight end, and usually David Johnson is the fullback.
Second and seven. And you got a false start.
False start. Offense number 73. 5 yard penalty. Second down.
Right guard Ramon Foster.
Who's been staring into the eyes all night of Lodi Nada.
Key plays on this drive. Early on, there's Nakamura's hold on Miller. There he was grasping the shirt as Roethlisberger went down and fumbled. And then on the fourth and one, they line up quickly, and they're able to get an encroachment foul. Now it's a tough game here, tough yard picked up by Mendenhall. Nada.
Wow.
With the tackle, and Flozell Adams is writhing in pain on the ground.
The Steelers can't lose any more offensive linemen. I mean, they are just, they've been through both their starting tackles, and now Flozell.
Injury timeout. Sunday Night Football brought to you by Windows 7, by Nissan. Innovation for today, innovation for tomorrow, innovation for all. By Shrek, the whole story on DVD Tuesday, December the 7th. And by Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Oh, yeah, crab cakes.
Pounded a few of those.
Baltimore. And there is Adams just getting to the bench. You've got Trey Essex coming in right now. He's going to play right tackle. They are depleted along that front. You've got five receivers here on third down and 11. And Ben is able to escape and throw on the run, and making the catch is Sanders at the 2 yard line. You had Nakamura coming in on the blitz and he couldn't get there, and bad foot and all, Roethlisberger able to slide to his right, extend the play. And that's 28 yards on third and 11.
I think Ben's loosening up. Nakamura made the miss. And let's see whether or not Sanders could have gotten up here. Nobody touched him. I don't think he was out of bounds. And you could see they were trying to basically drag him into the end zone. Antonio Brown was.
That's the end of the quarter. End of three. Baltimore 10, Pittsburgh 3. Sunday Night Football for Baltimore continues after these messages. To the fourth we go. Al Michaels, Chris Collinsworth, Andrea Kramer. The battle for first in the AFC North. And again, bigger for Pittsburgh, because if Baltimore were to win, they'd lead by a game, but in effect lead by two by virtue of a season sweep. First and goal. The ball is at the 2 yard line as we start the fourth quarter. And the handoff goes to Redmond, and he gets taken back. First guy to get there is Suggs.
And Al, they've got issues here, because typically the Pittsburgh Steelers want to run to the right against Flozell Adams or behind Flozell Adams, or they want to go that three tight end package. Well, neither of those options are available because of the injuries to Matt Spaeth, to Heath Miller, and Flozell Adams. So this is a tough spot here. Probably have to throw the ball.
Second and goal. Wallace to the left. Ward slot right. And instead they're going to run it. And Mendenhall goes nowhere. And once again, that Suggs has made two big stops. They're down and goal now.
Can't block them. You just can't do it. They've tried. They've tried with everybody. He has almost single-handedly won this game tonight. He is nightmare for Ben Roethlisberger right now.
Third and goal. Quick flip. Wallace stuck at the 1.5. by Landry. Fourth and goal.
They are going to kick the field goal here. This is just, we'll give it a shot. Put your head down. And if Wallace doesn't do that little dance to start with, you never know. He made it to about the 1.5 as it was. I don't know who he's juking there. It's one of those, maybe you put a big old guy like Hines Ward out there and say, Hines, go get me 5 yards.
Landry and Fabian Washington stopping him. Squeeze him for a 19-yard field goal attempt. Sepulveda holding. It's a low snap. Sepulveda gets it down, and the kick is just inside the left upright to make it a 4-point game. 10-6, Baltimore, early fourth. Sunday Night Football brought to you by GE, Imagination at Work, by Audi, Truth and Engineering, by Head & Shoulders, respect the scalp, get the hair, and by AT&T, rethink possible. Johnny Unitas, the best there ever was, from Pittsburgh, of course, made his mark right here by Chesapeake Bay.
We want to clean up one thing as well. We went back and watched the replay, and Emmanuel Sanders was touched by Ed Reed when Reed was leaping over the top, so he did not have the opportunity to get up and try and run this thing in. And this is sort of what we expected this game, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, and then you had the goal line stand there. That was one of those rare 9.5 minutes, 79-yard, 16-play drives, but they were held to a field goal. Flag is down at the 35-yard line, and for the moment, you've got a touchback by Cundiff. And McCauley checking with his crew. But you're going to have an offside here, which is going to take the kickoff back to the 25-yard line.
Offside, kicking team number 84. 5-yard penalty, free kick.
The game again tonight of paramount importance in the division, in the conference. There they are at 8-3. And it's the 43rd game between teams tied for first place in the division final 5 weeks of the season since the merger back in 1970. And the team that won the game won the division 37 times. So we're coming down toward the end of the season, and it would figure. Of course, in Baltimore's case, again, they would have, in effect, a two-game lead because of the winning both games. Pittsburgh would have a one-game lead, and there are more graphical evidence of how tight these teams are in almost every category.
I'll tell you, Al, there is a significant wind blowing at the Steelers' back here for the fourth quarter, and it could have a major impact here. The decision here to let him kick it again. Be interesting to see how far he's able to kick this one with this win.
I was talking about Cundiff before. We squeeze him with the kickoff for Pittsburgh. And this time the kick is fielded at the 6-yard line by David Reed. After the 35-yard line. So Flacco and company coming out. Started to talk about Flacco before. He has an interesting confidence.
Yeah.
Since his third year in the league, and we were talking about the fact that when they turn the ball over, the Ravens defense is not allowed a touchdown this season. And so he feels he can take more chances and open it up a little bit. And now, well, you know, when we're opening it up that way, is Dante Stallworth gets taken down by Lamar Woodley. Little razzle-dazzle, and all the razzle-dazzle belongs to the defense on that one.
You know what? They're just so well coached. Don't go chasing down the line. Play the bootleg. Play the reverse. There you go. And now you've got issues for the Baltimore Ravens. You're up against one of the top defenses in the league, and you're sitting there second and about 21 now. You take a chance. You try and create something, but Dick LeBeau's guys don't make silly mistakes.
73 years old. The Hall of Famer Dick LeBeau, second down and 21. Three-man rush, dump it off to Rice underneath. He gets it back out to the 35-yard line. And it will be third down and 8 for the Ravens.
The one thing that the Ravens have not been able to do tonight is create one-on-one matchups in the passing game with Ray Rice. If you remember the game we called here last year, one of the deciding plays was a man coverage one-on-one route, and Rice really feels like he can beat either one of these inside backers if presented the opportunity.
Third and 8. Here come the Steelers. Flacco gets it away, and it's tipped by Stallworth and incomplete. Fourth down. So Pittsburgh, after that long drive, they force a three and out and get the ball back.
I'll tell you, one thing that people don't appreciate about James Harrison is his ability to cover. That time he dropped back. They didn't rush him that time. He got back in coverage, got a hit on Stallworth, and forced the punt.
Kurt Warner appreciates it.
Yeah.
100-yard return in the Super Bowl. And that's fielded by Brown at the 17-yard line. Ben and company taking over there. Fourth quarter. Thursday, holiday comedy. Special animated community, a holiday 30 rock, and a one-hour office Christmas. All new comedy Thursday night right here on NBC. Baltimore MD on this first Sunday night of December from the 16-yard line. Steelers down by 4. Begin this drive. On the ground is Mendenhall. Gain of 1. Some key injuries tonight. First play of the game, you had Todd Heap out with a hamstring. Heath Miller, he has a concussion, so he is done for the night. Flozell Adams, we saw him get hurt on the last series. Ankle, questionable. Roethlisberger had the nose on the first series, but Ben, none the worse for wear. The foot's been fine.
I tell you, the one they better worry about now is the loss of Flozell Adams.
Second down and 9. Ben, underneath drop, Mendenhall. Hey, Chris, you were mentioning you couldn't believe that they didn't call a foul on the hit by McLean, the linebacker, on Miller. And here it was. Carl Johnson, the head of officials, has told us within the last few minutes that there should have been a foul called on that play.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Which also means that McLean's going to probably get a fine.
Oh, yeah.
That probably. Third and 9. From the 18-yard line. Roethlisberger pressured, stepping up, throws, and there's a flag down. There's Wallace making the catch, and for the moment, it's a temporary first down.
Illegal formation, offense, 6 men on the line of scrimmage, 5-yard penalty, third down.
And that's why it's only temporary.
Well, there must be saying that this tackle is off the line of scrimmage here, because you've got here and here and 5 offensive linemen. So that must be the call. And you can see his helmet was not up to the waistline of the center. Well, that's a tough call in this situation.
Well, again, that's Adams' spot, right, occupied by Essex.
He's a guard who's not used to being out there and needs all the help he can get.
Third and 13. Three-man rush, 8 covering, then extending, chased by Suggs. Lost one out of bounds. Good defensive series for the Ravens.
Well, Marquise Pouncey is one of the premier young players in the game, but Haloti Ngata, for my money, is the best defensive tackle in the game. He just took Pouncey and drove him straight back. And on the back end, Ed Reed was sitting and waiting for the interception. Roethlisberger saw him and threw it out of bounds.
There's the ball to Hurd. Here comes Sweezen. Second punt, and he just does get it away. It's not a thing of beauty, but at least he gets it across the 50-yard line, and it scoots out of bounds at the Baltimore 48. 9:46 left in regulation. 10-6 Baltimore. Tomorrow it's the sing-off of both the competition where their voices are the instruments. The sing-off returning tomorrow night right here on the National Broadcasting Company. Baltimore, Maryland. On the Sunday night, first and 10 for the Ravens after Sweezum's 39-yard punt. And Rice takes the ball into Pittsburgh territory.
You know, we've talked about it. Excuse me. We've talked about a little bit how they're trying to block James Harrison. You see they bring the extra offensive tackle in over here and move a tight end there, which really means that Lamar Woodley should be making even more plays because he has the tight end there. But when he comes up the field, it just creates a little opening. Of course, he's got a lot of help in behind him, so he's not too worried about that.
And there is Flozell Adams going back to the locker room. Second down and 7. Rice runs into a lot of traffic and gets back to the line of scrimmage. Tackled there by Farrier as we tick down under 9 minutes. It'll be third down and 6.
Well, James Farrier, for an older guy, makes about as many plays as you'll see. He's got to be 34, 35 years old, something like that.
Yep.
And you put on the tape and you don't see it. Most guys that age, you see it. But James Farrier, he can still run, and he catches plays from the backside just like he did there.
14th year in the league. But it's college football at Virginia, third down and 6. Blitz, and then Flacco has that one tipped. Tipped by Kiesel. And that time you had Timmons racing in to put the heat on.
You sure did, and Ben Grubbs just saved Joe Flacco. I mean, with the last second, watch him right here. Timmons going to come around, and Grubbs sees it right at the last second, gets just enough of him to knock him off. Game of inches sometimes down the field. But Kiesel making a play that they were hoping he'd make, knocking down a few balls, too.
Hook the punt. Randall L. back. Calls for the fair catch at the 12-yard line. 8:14 remaining in the fourth quarter. Baltimore by 4. Aerial coverage from Baltimore being brought to you by the film The Fighter. Inner Harbor, Baltimore. 8:14 to go. Fourth quarter. Hines Ward has only caught one pass tonight and been targeted but twice. From the 13, they begin this drive with a pass to the right side. That's caught by Wallace. He gets tackled at the 20. Gain of 7.
And Flozell Adams basically was rolled up on by Haloti Ngata, and it was one of those plays that he just beat Marquise Pouncey so cleanly that he was able to go back door and get the play, and it ended up costing him the starting tackle.
Second and short from the 20-yard line. Rushing 4. Then able to pull it down again. Finds Wallace. Escapes. Out past the 40 to the 42-yard line. Broke away from a Josh Wilson tackle for a first down.
Tell you, watch the way Mike Wallace accelerates after this catch. He sees a little opening. And then he does a little Usain Bolt thing here. Ben Roethlisberger, though, is starting to feel it. He's moving better. He's getting back to the pump fakes. He's playing like Ben. And he has usually been pretty darn good in the fourth quarter of games.
Roethlisberger tonight, 20 out of 34 for 238. Mendenhall. It's jammed up. Lewis is right there at the line of scrimmage. Give him a gain of 1, second down and 9.
Well, Ray Lewis, he knows all too well that the clock is ticking on his career, and this game is huge. The winner of this game, in all likelihood, is going to end up with either the number 1 or 2 seed and a bye the first week. If it's the Ravens, they are in great position to make a Super Bowl run.
Second down and 8. feeling it, stepping up. And tackled at the 44-yard line. That's Corey Redding. Forcing the issue and getting credit for the sack, a one-yard sack.
Unbelievable, the receivers ran into each other. You got Hines Ward going to come across the field, and he's going to run right into David Johnson, the tight end. They were trying to pick him off, and they ran into each other. And then Ben had nowhere to go with the ball.
And Johnson in there in this circumstance because of the concussion sustained by Heath Miller. Third down and 10. Here come the Ravens. It's dumped off on the outside to David Johnson, and he gets taken down at the 50-yard line by DeJuan Landry. It'll be fourth down and 4.
Well, that was a little fire zone that the Ravens threw back at Dick LeBeau right there. That looked like a Pittsburgh Steelers blitz on that one. And I tell you, for this young man right here, he better catch this thing. Sean Sweezum has been bobbling these balls, and last time they got really close.
Ed Reed making sure he's got 10 partners out there. He's going to let it bounce at the 11-yard line, and then he's going to pick it up at the 4-yard line and get taken down right there. And there's a flag down. So Sweezum with his third punt of the night. But a marker. Terry McCauley has had a very active night. 9 penalties on Baltimore accepted. 6 against Pittsburgh tonight.
Wow, that's big. That is big. Make the field goal kicker kick it again. Yes, sir.
Flyer went out of bounds on the punt on the kicking team. 5-yard penalty. Replay fourth down.
Very big.
Gone out of bounds and stayed out of bounds and took advantage. Well, you can be forced out if you're Keenan Lewis, but you can't do that and just run down the boundary. And that is monstrous. They had them pinned back inside the 4-yard line. Wow.
So Sweezum kicking, Sepulveda with a right leg injury. Chris talking about Sweezum having trouble accepting the snap, and he's going to have to accept another one right here. And now Ladarius Webb goes back to receive this punt instead of Reed,
who had the big return earlier in the game. Let's see. Sweezum is trying to catch these punts in his belly instead of in his hands,
which he does right there. A little basket catch, wobbly spinning kick, fielded at the 16-yard line. And he brings it back to the 27. So a 23-yard differential because of that penalty. Instead of the 4-yard line, they started the 27-yard line with 4:43. Roethlisberger, the bloody nose, which looked like it was broken on the first series, but he hasn't missed a beat. There are Flacco's numbers tonight. That one drive resulting in an Anquan Boldin touchdown, the only touchdown of the game. And of course, the key injuries starting with Heath, Miller with a concussion, Adams also coming out of the game, and here we go for the final 4:43.
Don't forget the Steelers wasted that one timeout earlier.
They only had 10 men on the field on a punt. So they have 2 plus the 2-minute warning. Willis McGahee is the running back as they start from the 28, and they give it to the former Buffalo Bill. And he gets stacked up to the 29-yard line.
One of the best run defenders in the NFL right here, Lamar Woodley. Watch this guy. One tight end, 2 tight ends. Forget it. And now Joe Flacco is going to have to put this ball in the air. You're not going to be that effective just trying to hand off in this situation against the Pittsburgh Steelers.
Yes, Pittsburgh, of course, would love a 3-and-out to save their timeouts. 2nd and 8. So put it in the air, and the pass is incomplete, and here comes a flag because Brian McFadden was all over Derek Mason.
Couldn't tell, but it looked like McFadden.
Pass interference, defense, number 20. Automatic first down.
Mason tries to arrow out of this route. Looked like McFadden grabbed him at the tail end. Let's see. Man coverage. just kind of hooked that arm on the inside. Boy, if he didn't grab him, that's good coverage that got called. Tough night for Brian McFadden.
First down up at the 38-yard line. Rice is back in. And now Flacco's going to take a timeout with the play clock winding down. Heath Miller, who sustained a concussion earlier in the second half, going back to the Pittsburgh locker room. And with Spaeth down tonight again, Pittsburgh down to one tight end, down to Johnson. Minus guys along the front. Been a rough night. Rice up to the 43-yard line.
Interesting there, Al, that they went nickel on first and 10, basically daring the Baltimore Ravens to run the football. They came out, they took defensive linemen out of the game and said, we're going to stop you with our nickel. Go ahead and run the ball, and they did, and picked up five.
Second and five, and of course Flacco will milk the clock as far down as he can. 3:25 and ticking down in the fourth. And he gets knocked down, and the ball is loose, and it's Polamalu. It's picked up by Woodley, and he gets taken down to the 10-yard line. Huge, huge play. Flacco going back, and unless that arm was coming forward, this will stand.
You knew it was going to happen sooner or later. James Harrison hard down inside. And Polamalu just so explosive, so fast. I don't know, I didn't see it. I thought the ball was out. No question.
Yeah, no question about that. You never know until you see the replay on a play like that. But the arm is not coming forward. Polamalu with the play of the game, and the ball is now inside the 10-yard line, so it's going to be first down and goal.
Remember, injuries to the tight ends, injuries to the starting tackle, Flozell Adams. Probably four passes here.
Mendenhall goes in motion to the outside. Ben.
Oh, my goodness.
And Ben with that sidearm pass, because Suggs was all over him.
That is one of the great plays I have seen in a long time. Suggs is going after the ball. He's going for the strip instead of the sack here, trying to knock it out, grabbing everything he can, trying to get the ball. Roethlisberger escapes, flips it out of there, and saves himself about 7 yards on the play. What a play by Roethlisberger. Also grabbed underneath the helmet, a shot to the head, all those things. What a play.
And Ben able to get out of the pocket so he could throw it away.
Wow.
Second down and goal. And now a timeout is taken.
Second charge timeout, Baltimore.
By the Ravens.
30-second timeout.
You can say anything you want about Ben Roethlisberger. That guy has sucked it up tonight.
He has.
And played with all the heart you could ever want. And not much help. They have not been able to block Terrell Suggs all night. This is unbelievable. It's as good a play as you'll see.
With the uniform still bloodstained from the bloody nose incurred on the first series of the game, with a shoe that's 1.5 sizes larger than it would normally be because it was built up to protect the foot. Clearly took a shot before the game. And there are the numbers, and especially in the second half. The old Ben.
Suggs is to Ben's left side again.
Second down and goal. And Roethlisberger, that pump fake, and then throws too high. Ward in the back of the end zone. No chance though. Third down and goal, with a tick under 3 minutes to play.
Well, now's when you begin to look to the back of the end zone. And this is when typically a Heath Miller in the back of the end zone would be your top option. He's not there. But if somebody can get to the back line, Let Ben scramble a little bit. We've seen him score a bunch of touchdowns to that guy right there, Hines Ward, in the past.
Ravens are coming. Gets it away quickly. Misses back. Redmond breaking tackles. Gets into the end zone. Touchdown Steelers. Isaac Redmond. The backup back. Not even the third down back. That's when they use Noeldy Moore.
Now, let me tell you how good a play that is. Isaac Redmond was in a position he had to make a hot read. They came with the blitz. He breaks it off and scores a touchdown. I bet you he hasn't practiced that twice in his life.
Sweezer now for the extra point. And the Pittsburgh Steelers, for the first time tonight, have the lead, 13-10.
Two of the more phenomenal plays I've seen this season. Here he is. Hot read coming. You expect it out of a wideout, but you get big Isaac Redmond out there. He breaks the tackle and scores. Simply phenomenal football by great football players, starting with Troy Polamalu and the play he made. Polamalu right here, untouched, didn't go for the sack, went for the sack fumble, and as he has done throughout the course of his career, the game changer. But this one's as good as I've seen this year. The stiff arm, the long arms of Ben Roethlisberger may have just saved their season.
Gets outside the pocket, so it's legal, and then Redmond.
Wow.
Breaking free at the 5-yard line, fighting his way into the end zone.
What a football game. You could play this one 16 times as far as I'm concerned. I'd come to them all.
So Baltimore with one timeout plus a 2-minute warning. David Reed, and what a great tackle that is by Sanders. Emmanuel Sanders. Stopping him before he can get loose at the 16-yard line. So Reed goes down there, and now Flacco comes out for the first time tonight, trailing in the game, 2:50 to play.
Now remember, this is exactly how the last one ended. Joe Flacco had to put together a drive at the end. He did. He hit the big touchdown pass to T.J. Houshmandzadeh with about 20 seconds to go. And here you go, Joe. You want to make a name for yourself, beat the Steelers twice in the late in the fourth quarter in the same year.
That was a 40-yard drive in Pittsburgh on the first Sunday of October. Pressure on Flacco, and Flacco's gonna go down at the 10-yard line. James Farrier bursting through. And Harrison got there to clean up.
That time Ray Rice missed. Here's Farrier. Ray Rice is gonna miss right here, and it's a big miss. Farrier's had 3 sacks, I wanna say, in the last 4 games. They're bringing pressure outside. Got there, now they bring pressure inside, get there. It's what makes Pittsburgh so dangerous. They can blitz any one of the 4 linebackers anytime.
Second down and 18 from the 10-yard line. And Flacco will throw, and it will be caught just short of the first down. Bolden out of bounds at the 28-yard line. Got position on William Gay and turns a second and 18 into a 3rd and 2.
Well, this time Ray Rice got the job done. Going to come over from the right side. There's Farrier there, and Rice gets it. Flacco has time to stand there. And Anquan Bolden beats the nickel coverage to give him a chance.
2:10. One timeout and the 2-minute warning for Baltimore. Play clock down to 0. Flacco underneath, and it's dropped at the 29-yard line by Houshmandzadeh. So 5 seconds shy of the 2-minute warning. It is 4th down.
What a job that time by James Farrier. What a battle with Ray Rice he's got going on. They had Ray Rice scattered out of the backfield, meaning no protection issues whatsoever, and it was Farrier who recognized it and ran with him. Here they're trying to get him on a wheel right down the sideline. It looks like he's going to be open, but Ferrier smells it out and runs right underneath the route to make the play.
And they have to go for it in this situation. Fourth and two with one timeout from the 26-yard line. Four-man rush. Pass caught. Bolden, 34-yard line. First down, and that takes us to the two-minute warning. What a battle.
Wow.
And you knew it was coming. 13-10 Pittsburgh. Right after the game, the Wendy's postgame report, Andrea with an interview. And Bob and the gang will wrap it up, and we'll look ahead to next week's game between the Eagles and the Cowboys. Now, Baltimore has already used two timeouts, one because the play clock was running down, the other defensively after Pittsburgh got the turnover first and goal. So they just have one with 1:56. Flacco stepping up, throwing into traffic, and that's caught. And what a series for Bolden. That's the reason you pick up a guy like that from the Arizona Cardinals. Polamalu and Clark with a coverage, 19-yard gain.
Great pocket presence by Joe Flacco. Stepped up right between the blitz and made a brilliant throw.
A minute and a half. Flacco stepping up again. Slings that one out of bounds. Mason looks for a flag, and there it comes. And again, they worked on McFadden.
Pass interference, defense number 20. Automatic first down.
Not even sure why he did it, but McFadden on the tail end of this, I guess he just doesn't see the ball, just going to push Derek Mason
right
out of bounds. And I guarantee you, before it's said and done, Brian McFadden is going to get plenty of action over there, and Tomlin's trying to say uncatchable. But the official was standing right down the sideline that made the call.
Yeah, and Mike is 53 yards away from the 39-yard line. Flacco hits him, leashes one toward the end zone and incomplete, and that's Clark batting it. And Harrison planting Flacco as he got rid of it.
Boy, James Harrison that time with a perfectly legal hit on Joe Flacco. Just as he threw that ball, the helmet off to the side. That's exactly how you're supposed to do it. Obviously not the dramatic effect. And Brian McFadden thought he had the one that was going to preserve his night tonight. Perfect tackle.
And instead, McFadden is slow in getting up and has to be assisted off the field. So they've been working on him. And of course, Flacco and Cam Cameron calling the plays, duly noting that.
I tell you, we should give some credit to Ryan Clark on that play as well. Not to get too technical, but they were in a quarters coverage and the post should have been there. Ryan Clark came from the backside of that play and made it. It was a guy that understood the situation.
And you saw Madison come into the game, and he's going to cover the slot man who is Bolden on this play. Second down and 10. Underneath, that is caught by Rice. And Rice will take the ball to the 35-yard line. So upcoming is a huge third and five with a minute. If you don't gain a yard here, do you try to kick a 51 or 52-yard field goal? You have only one timeout. Third and five. And the pass is
roll
out of bounds is Ed Dixon, but he can't. So the ball is in bounds with the clock still ticking at the 32-yard line. And now it is fourth down and two, and Baltimore will spend its final timeout. So if you're John Harbaugh right now, fourth and two, if there's such a thing as a prevailing wind in the stadium right now, where the wind swirls as it does in almost every stadium, you're kicking into it.
Well, Cundiff has had a tremendous year this year. 18 of 21 coming in with a long of 49 yards, which is about how long this one would be. But trust me, based on the kickoffs that we've seen tonight, That would take about a 55-yard kick, in my estimation, to get it there. Boy, this is a tough call here for a head coach. It looks like they're going to go for it. Most of those kickers know in pregame warm-up what their range is each way, and apparently for Cundiff, he didn't think he could get it there from here.
Not from 50, so they'll go for it on fourth and two with no timeouts. And Flacco trying to keep it alive, and he bounces one to Ed Dixon on the outside, and the Pittsburgh Steelers will take over and run the clock out.
Joe Flacco tried to go to Anquan Boldin on the right. It wasn't there. Boldin got held up on the outside. Ray Rice with a good block, and you can't see whether or not Ferrier got a piece of that or not. Here's the play on the outside. McFadden. Did he hold? Did he grab? Who cares? Doesn't get called. Does this one get tipped? No.
Nope.
It was just Joe Flacco. He was looking right. He was off balance. Saw the open receiver and just short-armed it.
And the Steelers come in here in that Paul Amalu play. You know, it's so interesting. I said live by the sword, die by the sword. He blitzes early on. You've got that huge completion to Boldin, which helps set up. Boldin was only touched under the night. So that works one way. And then, of course, he blitzes and turns in the play of the night, leading to the Pittsburgh touchdown and leading to the Steelers going into undisputed possession of first place in the AFC North.
Cannot give enough credit to Ben Roethlisberger either. Came in, bad foot, blew his nose up in the first few plays, hung in there the entire night. Great performance.
Farrier, big night as well.
What a football game.
Yeah.
I'm telling you what, if that's what the playoffs are going to be like, I can't wait.
Well, as I said at the outset, it's a bone-rattling rivalry, and it's one of the best in the league right now. Wendy's post-game report coming right up after the Pittsburgh Steelers beat the Baltimore Ravens by a score of 13-10. Troy Polamalu with the sack and the forced fumble and sets up a first and goal, and in they go for the touchdown to win it. Pittsburgh 9-3, Baltimore 8-4. And so it goes on Sunday Night Football.